One of the challenges we face today when we're trying to create an online project is that we want to find the right money sponsor when we have an online project. Somebody that can back you up into your idea for your business. What can you do, right? Well, if you stick till the end, I will give you my practical guide how to motivate your sponsors for your online projects. And I tell you, it's not gonna be the same as this. It's gonna be deeper. Hi, I'm Veronica Di Polo, and I used to be a professional conference organizer. I used to create events within Europe and Latin America with more than 10,000 participants. And today I am a personal branding consultant. I help entrepreneurs boost their business through their know-how so they can pivot their business through online projects. So back in the day when I used to organize events, it was very cut and dry. You would have an event, any kind, and you would go and look for sponsors and say, hey, I need money, you're in my industry, give me money, right? Straightforward. Then you give them a packages of different scale of money, they choose whatever they want, and they go for it, and that's it. Straight, right. Okay. Today, online projects is a little bit different. Still the same concept, right? But still, when I mean about online projects, and I really want to be clear here, when I mean about online projects is, I'm talking about trainings, workshops, courses, conferences, courses, memberships, virtual events, okay? We're clear? Okay. What most sponsors are searching today is something completely different than the old days. Things have evolved in a way. Actually, us as organizers, as course creators, as trainers, as associations, we have to be able to find the right way to bring in those sponsors. But what do they want? They want access. They want access to what you have right now and what you're offering to your participants, your audience, your students, they want all the details that you can give them, but they want real access. Sponsors today, they want access to your content. They want exposure. They want to be involved in whatever you're doing. You're asking them for money. I want access. I want to participate. I want to be there. I want to be part of whatever you're offering. That's what your sponsor really wants. Your sponsor also wants to have access to your database. What are the details and information that you have from your database that you can share with your sponsors? Yes, this used to be as well, but this is even further. I will tell you all the details, so don't worry about it. But before I get into the details, I want to explain to you the biggest question that I get everywhere, and I read everybody, and everybody's asking, which is, what can I give the sponsors to work with me? What can I do for a big brand or any kind of brand to work with me? If you've never worked with sponsors before, and this is your first time, and your first time doing an online project, and you've never had to reach out to anybody for money for your projects, then I really recommend you to watch my latest video, which was all about collaborating with others. I really highly recommend you to watch that before you start looking for sponsors, because that will give you clarity. The important thing when you're starting with sponsorships is that you should do it with the right step. And the first step before getting into sponsors is through collaborations. So make sure you watch that video and then you come back to this one and be sure that you're ready for this stage. So now going back to the same question that we were talking about before, what can you do, right? Well, sponsors in the end, what they really want is detailed information about your participants, meaning they want to track all their behaviors. They want to know where they, what they like, who is there, if their customers are there, if somebody that they've worked before is also gonna be in your online project or is participating in your online project or is part of your students. They want to know every single thing that you can give them. Not only that, they want to know the behavior of your participants, because the more they know, the more they're willing to pay for your online project. So depending on your niche and on your industry, they want to know the demographics, they want to know their buying behavior, they want to know what kind of things that they like to do, they want to know all the information. So let's say you are a tap studio and you have a membership of students that is just for moms that want to lose the mommy weight, okay? Let's think about that. It's just an example, it's just an industry that they do that, right? And you have a membership and you give your students these lessons online already and they go to see you. So what else can you give your students? Let's start with the students, okay? So what else can you give your students? You can give your students maybe discounts on their workout clothes. You can give, you can find also discounts on their tap shoes. You can actually give them information on small trainings with videos that blah, 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 okay? So as a sponsor, what can you ask a sponsor to help you? Now, think about this. These are your participants. These are your students. You know your students. You know what they want. You know what they need. You know what they would love to have. So when you think about your sponsors, think about who is the right sponsor for your online project, okay? So, which I want you to do is try and come up with ideas of thinking, okay, maybe my students, maybe I should find sponsors that are more involved into the shoemakers for tap shoes. Maybe I can actually convince those sponsors to either give shoes or they can actually give up big discounts to all my students, because maybe you have a good students and good bunch of students, and then they can get a discount for their shoes. Maybe you offer that sponsor to maybe give tutorials how to clean the shoes or treat the shoes in a certain way that they last longer. And you can even ask the sponsor to give trainings on how to do this. This is not a collaboration, people, okay? This is asking for a service for money, and you get, they get also information because they're gonna get clients as well. So for example, you're finding a podcast or somebody to talk about your workshop for your online project. That is a collaboration, okay? So try to be sure that whatever involves money, it's they're paying you and you are giving them something back. The thing with sponsorships, and this is what I feel most of the people today don't get it right, is that if you want to have sponsors, you have to be willing to give access to those sponsors. If you're not willing to give access to those sponsors, they will not pay. Plain and simple. Because today it's all about competition. It's who do you want that sponsor to be? Also today, sponsorships is about maybe a person, a brand, a personal brand as well. They don't have to necessarily be a big brand. So what I want you to do when it comes to this sponsorship is to think bigger and ask yourself the questions, what my sponsor would want. But actually, before you ask the questions of what your sponsor will want, I want you to ask the questions to yourself and about your online project. What do my people need? What do my participants need? What do they want? And ask them. Don't assume things. Ask them. You can have a, how do you call it? The questionnaires. Oh my God. Yeah. You can ask them through questionnaires, and you can ask them, even if you're seeing them and talking to them, ask them, what would you like? What kind of things would you get? What would interest you the most? So that then you can go and create a list of things and of people that you may know that they can fill those gaps. So I would suggest to go to 3 small businesses that you may think that can really help your finances right now, and also your online project to make it better. That's the goal, okay? Don't think big, think small if you're starting out. And if you're already in the big leagues, then you have to give them access. They have to be able to be part of your content. They have to be able to have and know everything about your participants and track them and network with them. So try to be sure that if you're gonna get sponsors, you have to be willing to put in the work, okay? So now that is the time that if you wanna get my practical guide to motivate sponsors to work on your online projects, make sure you go down to the description, download it, and get your free copy, because everything that I've just said and more is there. It's even more detailed with more examples for you. And maybe for your niche. Not in your niche, not. Because your niche is your niche. You are expert in what you do, not me, okay? Make sure that you subscribe, you hit that bell, and be notified when I have a new video every Thursday. And if you like the video, give it a like and subscribe to the channel. Bye-bye.